Hello, I'm Mr. Anajara, retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And I hail from the Punjab, where the second coming of Jesus took place. His name was Satguru Nanak Devji. Satguru stands for Christ. Guru stands for a rabbi. But most of the people who call themselves Sikhs, they address Nanak as Guru. Guru means a rabbi. So they don't know that he was a Christ, a Satguru. So Sikhism is one in a million is a Sikh. And that's why Jesus said, as the lightning strikes in the east, light is there in the east, but people want money. If they want to do something, money is first. God is later on. As the lightning strikes in the east, flashes towards the west. West is the area of darkness, where people love to hear the word of God. That's why they are so much love Christ Jesus. But they haven't heard about Nanak, his second coming, and he was the greatest of all. So the light strikes in the east, flashes towards the west, that means people of the west, they appreciate, and so shall be the coming Son of Man, Christ Nanak. With this introduction, I will do Luke 8, verse 19 to 21. It is very interesting, because Jesus was preaching gospel, exposing the hypocrisy of the temple priest. The law, you know, Luke 16, verse 16, law and prophets were till John the Baptist. To apply law, you need a man, a judge, and that used to be the rabbi. And he will tell you, you know, that whether you have committed a sin or not. Sins are transgression against the moral laws in ignorance. That means the once-born people were committing sin. Not the twice-born. Twice-born people know what they are doing. That's why in John 9, the born blind person whose eyes Jesus opened, and Jesus put a remark. These blind guides, they are the blind guides of the blind. And one Pharisee or Sadducee, he overheard it. Ah, are you calling me blind? Then Jesus said, no, I know you are not blind. That means he is doing the thing knowingly. Twice born, hypocrite. So these people in the temple, they were doing things wrong knowingly, and they were hypocrites. But they were having people under their thumb, rulers. So when they found that Jesus is preaching and exposing their hypocrisy, then they organized a team and sent it to his village, Nazareth, to persuade him not to preach gospel, persuade his family rather than him, you know. So that team came to the Nazareth, went to the local rabbi and took him along with them to the house of Jesus. And they met Mary and his tribal foster brethren. And they told them what the chief rabbi has ordered, that he should not preach gospel, he should not tell, misguide the people. And they were telling he is misguiding, as they tell me, you know, that when I tell them, then they'll call me in one church in here in Reading, Carey Baptist Church, when I preach gospel, you know, and give them the leaflets, they call me in heretic, that There was on one Sunday, I went to attend Carey Baptist Church, and that passage came was, you cannot serve Mammon and God. And I was laughing, you know, this priest, he is working for money. He is serving Mammon. Let's see what he will say. So what he started, he opened his mouth, that among you is sitting a man who gives his own literature. Don't take it from him. He is a heretic. And I know it's so he's pointing at me. So I wrote to their church elders, you know, he has proclaimed me heretic. They did not bother. They also believed what the priest told them to do. So same, you know, those temple priests were sent to the house of Mary to persuade Jesus not to preach gospel that exposes hypocrisy. So that is why Jesus said, if you want to join me, in Jesus we don't follow him, blind people follow. We are not blind, we are twice born of spirit. We join hands with Jesus. He is our anointed elder brother. We have one Father, supernatural Father, which is Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. And we join hands with him to preach gospel. So that's why Jesus said, anybody who wants to join me, remember Jesus said after feeding the 5,000, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you have no part in me. Eating the flesh means what came out of the mouth of Jesus. This is the spiritual mouth. Eat it with this mouth. Take it to your heart, which is spiritual stomach. Then digest it with the teeth of logical reasoning. And then proclaim gospel from your own mouth. That is why St. Paul said in 2 Corinthians 3 that gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablets of heart. What is written down, they are scriptures, and scripture is highly forbidden. That means you are not allowed to take Bible with you. Bible is scripture. If you go and ask a question to these Bible people of the book, they will open the passage, then there's a cross-reference, they will cross-reference, they will make you fed up. And they are happy that they have satisfied me by giving cross-reference, but in their heart they have nothing. They are dead letters in their head. Christianity is a heart, not of the head. Samaritans always worked on Gentile Samaritan, always use their heart. The gospel or the laws were written over their hearts and not in their heads. So they could make exception, they could make discretion, you know. And laws, these Jewish people, their laws are written over their head or their head. So my soul that on Sabbath, if your house catches fire, they won't put it off. They will ring the rabbi according to the moral law. Ring the rabbi, tell us what to do. He will tell them, call fire brigade. But they won't call it. So these are the law. Letter killeth, spirit giveth life. So in Holy Spirit we have God, which is common sense. We should exercise it to get gospel. So what I am saying here, that to dissuade Jesus, they influenced their family, Mary and his surrogate mother Mary and foster brethren, that they should tell Jesus he is mad, you know, that he is going against our tradition. He should stop it. That was an order, command from the chief rabbi. And that's why Mary and his foster brother went to Jesus when he was preaching gospel to the crowd. They were listening. And Jesus knew the matters of their heart, so he did not care. That means you have to renounce, or you have to get rid of your parents to preach gospel. That's why Jesus meant. So, but you have to serve your parents, you know, if they are, but you don't obey, you don't go with them. Because if you go with them, then you are under their thumb. Then you are a female. That's why Thomas said, unless a female becomes a male, she can't enter into the royal kingdom of God. So if you are obeying your rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, or this dog collar priest, or your bishop, or pope, then you are the male. You are not male, you are a female. Male is one, as in John 9, the born blind person was giving the answers to the rabbi himself. He did not ask his parent what to say. Master of your own destiny. So people who are masters of their own destiny, they are male. And we are fishers of men, such men, not of the fishers of female, like the people who follow the Pope. They are spiritual prostitutes. And Pope is adulterer. Matthew 19. You can't make a following. You can't give their account to God. If you can't give your account to God, then you are adulterer. And those who follow you, they have missed the right path to God. They have gone astray. They have become the spiritual prostitutes. So where their super blind guide goes, and there go their disciples. Disciple mean, the root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline natural boys through the moral law of Moses. So with this introduction, let's go ahead with this parable. So Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which we call Satguru Jesus, according to St. Luke 8, verse 19 to 21. The surrogate mother of Jesus. Remember that the name of Jesus, Hebrew name is Yeshua, which is made of two words, Yah and Shua. Yah means Yahweh, and Shua means the primal Adam. So Jesus was the firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother of Jesus, and so was his Joseph foster father, and so were his brethren, you know, which was foster, not real. So was the surrogate mother of Jesus that was bearing the first fruit of Yahweh and his tribal Judah foster brothers came to him. But they were unable to join him because of the crowd. So he was preaching gospel to the people. So he was independent, solitary of their parents. He was not under their command. That is why Jesus said, unless you renounce your mother and father, you can't join me. Follow means blind people follow others. She was visited by the high profile rabbis from the temple, Jerusalem temple, to persuade her that her son Jesus is misleading the people from the tradition of our elders, and she should stop him from preaching gospel. That is why she was calling Jesus to come home so that she could rebuke him. Jesus did not care of her, as she was just a woman. In the beginning was the Word, and Word became flesh in the name of Jesus, and through the woman. And he had a virgin birth. And this is proved in his name. Yeshua means Yah is Yahweh, Yeshua means Adam. the firstborn of Yahweh, or Mary was sired by Yahweh, and not by any tribal man. As she was just a woman that gave him birth as a surrogate mother, Jesus' father was Yahweh, and that is why his name was Yeshua. Shiva and Shua mean the same thing. The firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam. He was told by the crowd, you know, when they see it, that he was not paying attention to her, because he knew what she was wanting to tell him, because he had the supernatural power. He was told by the crowd, "Your surrogate mother and your foster brothers are standing outside, and they wish to see you." That is, his own did not appreciate what Jesus was doing or preaching gospel. He said to them in reply, "My mother and my brothers," that means our relations in God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, are those who hear the word of God and act on it. So that is the case. You know, she wanted to dissuade him not to preach the gospel. So she was not her mother or relationship, you know, in God. She was rather trying to do the job of the Satan. That is what Jesus told the 5,000, that unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you have no part in me. Hope this will make clear, and it's very simple, but you need to be a person of spirit, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is common sense. Most of the people, they have no common sense. For example, Church of England is headed by Queen. Queen is a very rich woman, head of the Mammon in Great Britain. Her picture is on every pound and every coin. Now, you remember the rich man who came to Jesus? How could he be perfect? He does everything, prayer, everything. He said, then, how did you become rich? He became rich by fleecing poor, and the poor Lazarus was sitting at the door of a rich man because he was fleeced. Among the Samaritans, that disparity of the rich and poor was very small. Almost they were same. They were not caring money. They cared for men, as the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person. They were philanthropists. So, Queen, if she asks Jesus, how could she be perfect, and Jesus tell her to give away all her riches to the poor, what type of face she will pull right to the earth? And hypocrisy is there. These soldiers who died in World War I, in World War II, in the expansion of the British Empire, they died for king and country, and not to glorify God. But as she is the head of the Church of England, so her priest, you know, then there's stooges working for money and not for God. They said they glorified God, and they are still proclaiming that they glorify God. Whereas the Salvation Army people who helped the poor, our brother William Booth, you know, when Christmas time came, then the Church of England people used to go out, "Those who belong to Church of England, follow me." And then Baptists will go, and all those churches will go. And at the last, you know, who were left over, then our brother William Booth say, "Hey, let's come and join us, and let's enjoy Christmas." And they will sing and hymns and other things. They were singing from their heart. The others, out of hypocrisy. So these Church of England priests who work for Mammon and not for God, they are working for Satan. So Church of England is akin to Satan, while Church of Salvation Army people, they are akin to God, because their soldiers died for king and country and not to glorify God. So you need to have common sense to appreciate gospel. No common sense, no Holy Spirit, and no gospel. Our Father God blesses you.